Hello everyone and welcome to the Stream TIG channel. It's been a while guys since my last video. I've been a bit busy. So now working on a project. We got 6 joints, 30 inch stainless steel pipe, 310. It's specifically designed for high temperature applications. So this is the material they usually use for high temp. So business as usual, clean in and out, make sure pipe is prepped, bevel. In this case, pipe is prepped, we got a feather edge. The only problem issue with this, it's pipe is a really bad egg shaped, so not much you can do about it. I mean, you can, but it will require more time. And we kind of running well with a deadline, so gotta put dogs as much as you can all the way around, chase that bubble. Not much, you're not gonna chase it out 100%, but it'll fix high-low as much as possible. We got to split the difference. It's not going to be perfect. You can see the cowboy head, one spot, a little bit tight on the bottom. I'll try to keep maintain 532 gap, but it's not going to be all the way around. It'll be tight on one spot, a little bit wide on the other. You know how it goes. So I just put like over inch good solid tacks. It's like 6-7 tacks, all depends. Whatever the good spot is for weld, that's where I put tack. As you can see here on the bottom, it's like 1/8 up on the top is shoot, plus 532 even more. But it is what it is. I like a little bit bigger gap. As soon as once you start welding, it'll shrink. That's why you want to start on the tight spot first. As I said, we gotta chase the bubble. So bubble's not, you're not gonna get rid of bubble. As I said, just gonna show you like with a high low gauge, good on the top, pretty much good on the side, and the bubble is gonna be on the bottom. But the good thing is I'm not gonna roll this in position on the bottom, so we're gonna roll it like a quarter. There's other pipes here on the pipe stand, so that's why, as you can see here, there's like almost a quarter inch. So in the worst case scenario, we'll go in and do a little bit back weld. It's needed. We'll see how it's gonna go. As you can see here, it's less than quarter inch, but still lots for a stainless. Okay, this is Ben. This is my partner. He's doing some acetone cleaning and marking for the purge plugs that we handmade. Before we continue on, check Extreme TIG product. It's a TIGSleeve storage tube. Let me introduce you to TIGSleeve. This is TIG rod storage tube, a special design for TIG welders. Every unit is handcrafted, features an O-ring seal to protect your TIG rods from moisture, dust, and any damage. 37 inches in length, so it's gonna fit full-size TIG rods, weighing just 2.6 pounds with a 10-pound rod capacity. Strap it over your back to stay mobile and hands-free while you're climbing, crawling. Comes in 5 different colors and you can check it out on TIGSleeve.com. Okay, as I mentioned, this is a handmade purge plug that we made out of aluminum. You got 2 hoses that's gonna feed 4 holes. Each hose is gonna spurs our argon inside, and it looks like a bicycle rim. That's kind of idea is that design, and right in the middle is a bicycle tube actually, and then we got little valves, shredded valve, that's gonna inflate the plugs once installed. So this has been on a skateboard. It's a little bit easier to go in. Feel sorry for Ben, but unfortunately he's 20 years younger, so so all it has to do it. This is how it's installed. Once he set up on a marking spot, I'm just gonna connect to the air, and then bicycle tube is gonna inflate. It's gonna stay in place. I got pretty good seal, so the purge should be good. As I said, this is our little design. We're getting creative more and more. That's pretty good. You got a skateboard running inside a pipe. Okay, so for this project, we are using a liquid argon. As you can see, the ice already start forming outside as a double wall that tank. Liquid argon, this entire tank is actually the same as a 16-pack argon bottle, so it's a little bit, it's more handy. The only thing, you can't move it too much around, it'll just turn to gas. That's why you gotta keep it in one spot. The flow is awesome. So as I said, we got the two hoses, eight holes, 6-inch far away from the joint. That's pretty good. So this is ER310. I'm gonna use a 1/8 rod and welding with this beauty. Dynasty 210, 120 amps is gonna be my start point. And then build, adjusted up, five up, up five, down five as needed. As I said, I'm just gonna roll that bottom section because it's too tight and I want to do the overhead. No need, as I said, we're in the shop, so just a little bit, roll it quarters, weld as much as we can. So I was keeping one, for one section, I was keeping rod inside, but it started shrinking even more, so I'm just gonna pull it out. As you can see here, I'm just pulling it out and from the outside. On the 120, I'm just pushing it in, try to cover both edges. I'm kind of trying to keep it right in the middle, like a water feed. Keep it like constantly connected, but I'm just a little bit losing connections here, and just opening edges. So I'm gonna dip side to side. Be a little bit shaky here. As I said, this is my first project in almost 2 months. A little bit out of shape, but I'm getting back. No worries. Okay, so we did that quarter section. That was bottom side. Now we'll be on the side. 1/8 tungsten, cup size 8, as always. And I'm using that heavy here, TIG torch, TIG rig. Now I'm gonna go on the side, all the way up to the top to 12 o'clock. Pretty much dipping technique here. This is one section with that high-low. From the outside, so the issue was on the bottom, we had a high-low on the bottom, on a bevel. This is for high-low for the outside. Not a big deal, I mean, we'll fix it with a cap. Gonna be a two-pass cap. There you go. So the one side, as you can see here on the right side, that's where the high-low is. And I'm trying to dip more, put more on the other side. I'm dipping actually both sides. Both sides, you can see it's opening quite a bit. Just gotta follow your travel speed and everything. Gotta slow it down here just to see. So you got a clear picture, better idea of what's going on here. Really happy with the purge. That was the biggest issue when we were setting up. We didn't know if it's gonna work or not, especially on a 30-inch diameter. You know, there's always issue with that. Like on the last project, we were working on an Inconel 24-inch, and the purge was a big issue, even though we were using purge bags. I'm not really a big fan of the purge bags. We had big issues with the purge. I did it. I know some other guys did as well. Yeah, I like this way better than the purge bag. Purge bag is not only one diffuser in the middle, that's not enough for a big pipe diameter. They gotta be at least 5-6 hoses on a big diameter. As you can see, the coverage, the argon was really good for purge. It's nice and shiny, that's all matters. We did cover the high-low spot. I just, after root pass, I went to site to double check if everything is good. If I had to do any touch-up, it will be before I do a hot pass. Everything was all right, so we did a hot pass. It's already done. I'm just going to do one pass fill. And it'll be two pass fill to flush and then two pass cap. I'm still sticking with 1/8 cup. As you can see, that bottom high-low, just gonna run one pass fill, and then another will be fill to flush, buff it off, and get ready for capping. For the fill and for the hot pass, I'm running 170 amps here, using the Dynasty 210. It's a pretty good machine. I like it. It's an AC-DC machine, you can do both. Really, runs really smooth. And 310, like 310 filler wire, it's not really bad at all. I contain more chromium and nickel inside. It's a little bit different than 316, but it's pretty much the weldability is almost similar. Pretty much, I would say the same. It's different material though, but for welding, it's really similar to 316. Because 316 is more like corrosion resistant material. That's why it's application they use it in marine and chemical industries and stuff like that. This is more like for furnaces, heat exchangers and stuff like that, where high temp is required. As I said, first fill is done. Now I'm gonna run the second one. This is my partner on the other side, welding the other side. So I'm doing back and halves. It's not really a big fan of that, but on the 30 inch, yeah, sure. I don't mind actually. Okay, now this one will be filled to flash. I didn't show, but I switched to cup size 10. Still 170. That's pretty good amperage for this. You don't have to go too crazy. 170 is okay. I filled the flash. Try to stay inside, right up to the edges. Make sure those corner inside the barrel are covered. That's why I like to use those tight steps, as you can see. So I got a really good control. I can see what's going on. Just watch the puddle. Even though it looks simple, it can be tricky sometimes. Especially when your bevel steep on the one side. So you kind of have a little warp hole. You can just walk over it and leave that like a tunnel underneath. That's why I like running hot. When your puddle is really liquid, it's easier to cover all that. Okay, now I'm just gonna buff it off, make it ready. Wait, maybe 10, 15, 20 minutes, doesn't matter, just for the cool off a little bit. It'll be easier to put a cap, as you can see here, high-low. It's not too bad. We'll just cover it and just gonna go on the one side, we'll start at the lower spot. I kinda do the build-up, and then I start welding on this case, I'll start on the left side, and here will be one bead on the left, and then the second bead right on a higher spot on the right side. So for the first pass, if you wanna make it look it nice, just pay attention to your sides. Make sure you got a straight edge. Try to follow that edge on the pipe side. For inside, it doesn't really matter. You're gonna cover it, overlap it with a second pass or your second bead. That's all about it. as I said, I always said in my video, guys, that's your signature. You want to put some pride to it. That's how you get recognized. Same thing for the cap 170. Okay, this is the first pass of the cap is done. It's my partner, he's doing good on the other side. Now I'm just gonna go second pass. Same amperage, same cup size 10, same thing. So my hopes are when I do the second pass on this is gonna cover enough. Yeah, I mean, it'll still be visible that was a high loss spot, but it doesn't really matter, guys. As long as it looks nice and it's covered, there's no undercuts, that should be good. This is my TIG sleeve in action. You can see it right here. It's really handy.
Good.
I know lots of people who bought it actually happy, and I'm really happy to hear that. It's practical, it works better than all the plastic stuff. It's good to hear the feedback, the people are happy. I mean, I'm using it as well. It's not like a one-time thing. I think it's gonna last for a while, absolutely. Okay, and this is the second pass. As always with the second pass, if it's the final pass, keep an eye on the bolts, both sides, make sure they're straight. Nice. Try to maintain to be straight as much as possible. And that's it. Two pass cap done. Walk in the cup. My partner is striking with the free hand, which is all right. Better take time, but they do it properly. As long as no repairs, that's all matter. It doesn't matter. Not everybody's walking the cup. Some people freehanding, in this case, my partner. So I like to walk the cup, finish it faster, and then I go for a smoke break. Okay, that's it. As I said, it's been a while since my last video. I hope now the season starts, there'll be lots of projects, so I hope there's gonna be more videos. Thanks for watching, guys. If you like it, share, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to subscribe, so click the bell icon button as well, so you keep up to date for all the content that's coming out. And see you in the next one, guys. Take care.